Hello, welcome to a series about shame and how to overcome shame. Let's start with the difference between shame and guilt. These two are mixed up together because they often are used in the same sentence, like, oh, there's no need to have shame and guilt, and oh, we suffer from shame and guilt. There's a connection, of course, between shame and guilt, but there's a difference. And the best way to explain both the connection and the difference of shame and guilt is to present it as a sequence. And it starts with shame and it ends with guilt. So the sequence is A goes to B, B goes to C, etc. Now there's another sequence next to it. It's the sequence where there's no shame. And let's call it this sequence of purity. Now, the sequence of purity starts with courage. There's a lot of talks from Brené Brown. She's an expert on shame. And she talks a lot about courage. So we can use the word courage here. There's also other words we can put there, like willpower, honesty. So honesty, willpower, and courage are the absence of shame. The reason I put shame first is that shame is a root mechanism. I use the word mechanism because it's a reaction to a rejection. So if somebody puts you down, you can end up with shame. And we will look at this mechanism more in later episodes of this series. Often people refer to shame as an emotion, but shame is not an emotion. It's a mechanism. The mechanism of shame is best explained as a closing down of energy. And shame is a freeze reaction. It's a shutdown movement. And it's more like a defense mechanism, as opposite to courage, which is a forward movement. It's reaching out. It's taking steps of courage. So the absence of shame would be courage. The word cœur in French means heart. It's a heart energy, a healthy reaching out of energy. So when there's no shame, basically there's courage and there's willpower. And when there's shame, the power of will is corrupted. Courage is also honesty. So what will happen in your life when you either live a life of courage or a shame-based life? Let's look at these next steps in this sequence. So courage is a heart emotion, a heart energy that's outgoing, it's reaching out, and we naturally want to connect to other people. And this is human. It is also vital that we connect emotionally, physically, and spiritually. We need others to feel accepted, to have a sense of belonging. And shame, on the other hand, prevents us from connecting. It shuts us down from sharing our pain and perceiving the pain from others. In other words, it isolates us. So the two opposites, isolation versus connection, are the next step in after shame versus courage. So there's a whole universe of where these two can spin off. It's too much to explain in this video, but it has a lot to do with feeling or not feeling emotions. So we're going to the direction of emotions here. Each emotion has a specific frequency. And isolation is the next step from shame, is probably the most dense, low feeling. It's the lowest frequency in the table of frequencies of emotions. And we can't survive without connection. Being disconnected is probably our greatest fear. So connection is life enforcing. We connect with our loved ones, with ourselves, with source. It's a primary necessity. We can't live without connection. So where do we go from here? So loneliness, depression, the feeling of being cut off is a breeding ground for many, many types of diseases. Isolation is the most painful emotion, and isolation is linked to pain. Mental pain, heart pain, and even physically pain. Connection is linked to healing. Think of a mother holding a child. The energy is free-flowing. There's a saying, love heals all wounds, right? Love is linked to connection and to healing. When we are frozen in shame, it's very difficult to get out of a hurtful situation. We look for ways to numb the pain. And numbing is really mainstream. Think about numbing in drugs, numbing with alcohol, numbing with hard work, with sex, with all kinds of drugs abuse, but also watching TV, watching our iPhones, watching everything outside of ourselves to numb the feeling of isolation. And we numb our feelings most of the time because it's so mainstream, we don't even know we're doing it. When I'm not in pain, when I'm able to feel my emotions and act accordingly, it's more likely that my behavior is not inflicting pain to others. And likewise, when I'm in pain, it's a very thin line, a small step to inflict pain to others. So suppose we are aware of our emotions, we are able to feel them, and they say to heal, you need to feel. When I'm not in pain, it's more likely that my behavior is not inflicting pain to others. If I'm numbed, if I'm crushed with pain, it's very easy to take a step of hurting others. When I'm in sync with my feelings, it's more likely that I have healthy behavior. When you're in touch with your feelings and when you're not frozen in shame, you're more capable of responding to those feelings in a healthy way. So it means, for example, when you feel angry, you can express this in a healthy way by, for example, setting boundaries, or that you are able to meet your needs. You can have an open discussion about your feelings. Whereas in shame, you're not capable of expressing, let alone feel, any of those needs. So suppose you're in a healthy relationship with your feelings, you can act accordingly. And healthy actions lead to a happier life. And toxic actions lead to an unhappy life. When I'm very busy to avoid feelings, my actions will be accordingly. For example, numbing my feelings can be done by distracting myself with behavior that not feeds my needs. Here is where guilt steps in. This can be guilt towards the self, towards others, towards God. The difference between guilt and shame is that guilt comes later and it's more tangible. It's something you can hold and you can apologize. It's an awkward feeling, but it's manageable. And shame is not manageable. Shame is more intangible. It's much more the awareness of being flawed, being bad, and you can't change. Whereas guilt is the feeling that I did something bad. And you can say, okay, sorry, I made a mistake. Guilt is the feeling you have after regretting. So guilt is more a regret, whereas shame is the root cause of doing things you will regret. So it's at the start. One can also say being frozen in shame prevents movement, it prevents a positive life change, and it prevents connection. Whereas courage or willpower, or unfrozen state, is the ability to move forward. In courage, the will is not broken. Where do shame and courage come from? In many spiritual teachings, there's a difference between the outside world and the inside world. Chasing happiness in the outside world may not be everlasting. We create dependency on things that give temporary happiness. What would it be if I say that happiness is already in me? I am, in essence, not flawed as shame suggests. I'm an eternal being of light, love and happiness. I am already that. Then shame has no place in my life. Shame is closely related to the perception of being the body and not the spirit. In the next episodes, we will look closer to shame. And we will find that a lot of shame is rooted in thinking that I'm a physical being. One could also say body consciousness, versus soul consciousness. Okay, more about this later. In the meanwhile, please subscribe and visit our website for more information about this topic.